نستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم أرسله الله بالحق بين يدي الساعة بشيرًا ونذيرًا وداعيًا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجًا منيرًا فمن يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل وغوى ولا يضر إلا نفسه ولن يضر الله شيئا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم من همزه ونفخه ونفثه يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم وقال الإمام البخاري رحمه الله تعالى في جامعه قال حدثنا أحمد محمد بن سنان قال حدثنا فليح عن محمد بن هلال عن عطاء بن يسار عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى قال ومن يأبى يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من أطاعني دخل الجنة ومن عصاني فقد أبى أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام My dear brothers and my dear sisters, this earth which we live upon and this life which we are living has been made for us as a test for us. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. That is, blessed is He subhanahu wa ta'ala, in whose hand, in His control, in His yad is the whole dominion. And He has power over all things. He who created life and death, this life which we are living, in order to test you, who among you is best indeed. As Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, as in Sahih Bukhari, he said that Al-Yawm Al-Amal Wala Hisab Wa Ghadan Al-Hisab Wala Amal. Today there is performing good deeds is for today. Today is the time for you to perform good deeds and there is no reckoning upon you. Whereas tomorrow on Yawm Al-Qiyamah, there will be no chance for you to perform any deed. There will only be recompensed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only being held to account by Allahu Rabbul Alameen. And there will be no chance to perform any deed. This life which we are living in is a life of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala putting us to test. Who among us is the best in this life? The best in the way that they perform their deeds, the best in the way that they carry themselves, that they act in accordance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or in obedience to their own desires, in obedience to shaitan. This is the reality of this life. That it is not for us just to relax and to sit back and enjoy this life. But this is for us to be tested by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. وَنَبَلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. We will test you in times of prosperity, times of ease, and likewise times of hardship, times of difficulty. Both of them are a test, a fitna by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنَبَلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. Both of them, they are a type of trial for us, a type of testing for us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the way our whole life is a test by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Then there is one ayah of the Quran, one ayah in Surah Ali Imran, which the Aimah of Tafsir they term as Ayatul Mihna. The way our whole life is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then there's one ayah of Quran which is called and which is termed as the ayah of testing by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That one ayah which is used as a test to test whether you are loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands, قُلْ tell them, O my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ. Say, if truly you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as is the claim of every believer to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as was the claim of those who came before us, that the Yahud and the Nasara, what did they say? نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ اللَّهِ وَأَحِبَّاؤُهُ. We are the children of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are His beloved, and we are His أَحِبَّاء. We are those who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If this is your claim, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ, because your claims may be many, but claims may also be empty. وَكُلٌّ يَدَّعِي وَصْلًا بِلَيْلَى وَلَيْلَى لَا تَقِرُّ لَهُمْ بِذَاكَ. That everybody they may claim to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but that is not the actuality. The fruit of it is not in what you are claiming, what your da'wah is. Everybody claims to love Layla, but Layla, she does not affirm that love for any of them. Because claiming is easy to claim you do this or you do that or you are this or you love that. Claiming is very, very easy. But to express your claim, to fulfill, to personify the claim which you are making, that is where the actual test is. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ. Say, if you claim to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that should be the whole purpose of our life. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love us, they say in Arabic, لَيْسَ الشَّأْن أَن تُحِبْ بَلِ الشَّأْن أَن تُحَبْ. It is not the affair that you love, because everybody they claim to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, بَلِ الشَّأْن أَن تُحَبْ. Rather, the actual amazing affair is, if you in turn to loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves you tabaraka wa ta'ala. That is what is more important, أَن تُحَبْ, that you are loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you are loved by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, this should be the goal of our whole journey of life, to become mahbub to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? لحيث مصدرك حاكم and مسند أحمد of Sayyidina Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala an, Ta'aw Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said that Wallahu la yulqi habibahu fi an-nar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will never ever cast His mahbub, His habib, His beloved, those who are beloved to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will never ever be thrown into the fire of Jahannam. That should be our goal, to become mahbub to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because then there is a guarantee, Wallahu la yulqi habibahu fi an-nar. And that is the actual success. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازِ. Those who they avoid the fire of Jahannam and they enter into paradise, then such a person has attained the actual success. And one of those ways to become mahbub to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to guarantee yourself paradise, is to become beloved to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَبْطِشُ بِهَا وَرِجْلُهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا وَلَئِن سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّ وَلَئِن اسْتَعَاذَنِي لَأُعِيذَنَّ. If somebody becomes mahbub to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in Sahih Bukhari hadith Qudsi, he says that I become the eyes by which he sees nothing except the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his gaze turns towards, and I become the hearing by which he hears nothing except that which is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hand by which he grips, the foot by which he walks, and then وَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّ. If he asks me, I will give him. If he seeks protection in me, I will grant him my protection. To become mahbub to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ. If you claim to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاتَّبِعُونِي. Then the test of the actualizing of that claim is فَاتَّبِعُونِي. Then make ittiba of me, follow me, يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَلِكُ الْمُلُوكِ إِلَهُ الْعَالَمِينَ. He will love you in turn, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And He will forgive you of all of your sins. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is غَفُور and He is رَحِيم subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the way to personify your love for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The claim for your love for Allah dhul jalali wal ikram is to personify that by acting in accordance to what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, he has brought. fattabi'uni, fattabi'uni, follow me, nobody other than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Even a Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can you imagine? Following any other Nabi apart from our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi was in opposition to the irshadat, the hidayah, the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Take for example Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. Kaleemullah, wa kallamallahu Musa takleema. Nobody has any doubt, any shak in the high level of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. From the ulul azm rusul, from the well-determined prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him the Torah without any medium between him and Sayyidina Musa, directly gave to him the alwah, tablets upon the Torah was written upon Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. Yet in the Sunnah of Imam Darimi, Sayyidina Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَوْ بَدَى لَكُمْ مُوسَى. If Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam was to return, appear to you again, فَاتَّبَعْتُمُوهُ, and you went ahead and you followed him alayhi salatu wa sallam, Sayyidina Musa kaleemullah alayhi salatu wa sallam, وَتَرَكْتُمُونِي, and you abandoned me, you left me, you forsook me, you left my sunnah, my ahadith, and you follow Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, لَضَلَلْتُمْ عَنْ سَوَاءِ السَّبِيلِ, then you would be digressed away from the correct path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَضَلَلْتُمْ, you would have been misguided by following Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam in opposition to following the sunnah and the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. If this is the condition with any Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then how then with any ummati of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? Will that be guidance, hidayah, or will it be dalala and misguidance to follow somebody in opposition to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? That is the actual test of our lives, the testing of us. فَاتَّبِعُونِي, follow me, follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you in response to that. And if you do not, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, أَوْ يُهْبَلِيهُ, أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ, and obey his Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَا تُبْطِلُوا أَعْمَالَكُمْ, and do not allow your deeds to go null and void, to go into waste by making ita'a to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and making ittiba to other than his Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Our one way to gain the mahabbah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to restrict ourselves to making ittiba' of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li jami'il muslimina min kulli dhanbin fastaghfiruhu innahu al-ghafur. Bismillah. Alhamdulillah wa kafa wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina al-mujtaba wa alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Thumma amma ba'd. In Surah An-Nur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us who are the successful, those who have succeeded. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, whoever it is, that they show obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his fara'id, in what he has obligated upon somebody, وَرَسُولَهُ, and to his Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to his Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam, in what he has given to them from the tradition, from the way to live their life, وَيَخْشَ اللَّهَ, and they have khashya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, أي فيما مضى, in that which has passed by them, that which has passed by in their life, in the past, then they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reckoning of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He is the intiqam, he is the one who takes revenge subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَتَّقْهِ, and they have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أي فيما بقي من عمره, and that which is remaining in their life, they have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And such people, they are fa'izun, they are those who are successful in this life. They restrict themselves to only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to his Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they only have khashya of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, fear nobody other than Allah dhul jalal, and they only have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is all success combined in one ayah, a couple of words from Surah An-Nur. And all of us, we ask for guidance in every single rak'ah, in every single unit of our prayers. We ask and we beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, guide us to the correct path. However, many among us, our example is like the person mentioned in Surah Al-Ra'd, the one who is كَبَاسِطِ كَفَّيْهِ إِلَى الْمَاءِ لِيَبْلُغَ فَاهُ وَمَا هُوَ بِبَالِغِهِ, the one who is outstretching their palms towards some water to allow that water to reach into their mouth, وَمَا هُوَ بِبَالِغِهِ, but he is not reaching that water, though the water is right in front of his face, his arms are outstretched, but yet he is not moving forward to get that water. وَمَا دُعَاءُ الْكَافِرِينَ إِلَّا فِي ضَلَالٍ. Then our example is like that. We ask for hidayah, we want hidayah from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, but we are outstretching our hands and the water is in front of us. It is up to us to find out that hidayah, to go and to rush toward that hidayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to seek that. Hence, otherwise there is no point, there is no use of us asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, guide us to the correct path. We are making no active means to seek that guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyid Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Sayyidah Maryam alayhi salatu wa salam, she was in the pangs of childbirth, the pains of childbirth, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala commanded her, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًّا, that upon you, O Maryam, is not to ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and he will send dates flying from the sky. Rather, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ, pull towards, shake the trunk of the date palm, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will fall upon you, he will allow dates to fall upon you, rutaban jadiyya, those which are fresh, those which are moist, then they will come upon you by you shaking the trunk of the tree. See, similarly, we have to ask for hidayah and seek out that hidayah from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And where is that hidayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? For the guidance in this life, in the akhirah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions, وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا, there is hidayah, وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا, if you are to be obedient to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, تَهْتَدُوا, then you will be guided correctly. And those who they are aware of the qawaid and the usul and the affairs of nahw and sarf and lugha and balagha of the language, then وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا, this tarqib, the composition of this sentence, it يُفِيدُ الْحَصْرِ, it gives rise to exclusivity. Only and only, وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا, only and only if you obey him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, تَهْتَدُوا, then you will be guided correctly. If you do not, meaning if you do not obey him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you obey every single other human being on this planet, except for Sayyidu Waladi Adam Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will never ever obtain any guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا, if you are to obey him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, تَهْتَدُوا, then you will be guided correctly. As Imam Sufyan bin Uyayna rahmahullah ta'ala, he said that إِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam هُوَ الْمِيزَانُ الْأَكْبَرُ فَعَلَيْهِ تُعْرَضُ الْأَشْيَاءُ, he alayhi salatu wassalam is the greatest of all scales. Al-Mizanul Akbar, the greatest scale to weigh anything in is Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Upon him, upon his hidayah, upon his guidance, upon his seerah, upon his obedience, everything is weighed in our lives. فَمَا وَافَقَهَا فَهُوَ الْحَقِّ, whatever is in accordance to that, then that is the truth. وَمَاذَا بَعْدَ الْحَقِّ إِلَّا الضَّلَالِ فَمَاذَا بَعْدَ الْحَقِّ إِلَّا الضَّلَالِ فَأَنَّا تُصْرَفُونَ, and what is there after haqq except for dalal? Apart from truth, what is there other than misguidance and deviance? وَمَا وَافَقَهَا فَهُوَ الْحَقِّ, whatever is in concordance, whatever conforms to that mizanul al-akbar Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then that is the truth. وَمَا خَالَفَهَا فَهُوَ الْبَاطِلِ, and whatever is in opposition to that, that Mizanul Akbar, then that is al-batil, then that is no doubt, that is misguidance, and that is falsehood, taking you away from the way, the path toward Jannatul Firdaus al-A'la, taking you away from the path toward the mahabba of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must keep in our mind that he is al-mizanul akbar sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the greatest of all scales. There is no scale in opposition to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everything in our lives the way we carry ourselves, the way we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, must be weighed upon Him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, in His court sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in accordance to His ahadith sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in accordance to His sunnah alayhi salatu wa salam. Not the way anybody else apart from Him has shown us, has guided us toward, or misguided us toward, or has shown us this is the path. No. On Yawm al-Qiyamah, wa yawma yunadihim فَيَقُولُوا مَاذَا أَجَبْتُمُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. On Yawm al-Qiyamah, in Surah Al-Qasas, Allah subhanahu mentions that He will ask all of His slaves, مَاذَا أَجَبْتُمُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. What did you give in response, in answering to the call of my Mursaleen alayhim salatu wasalam? Nobody other than them, except the prophets and the messengers alayhim salatu wasalam. And all of their kamalat, all of their irshadat, all of their manaqib have been gathered in Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. In our qubur, in our graves, we'll be asked, مَا كُنْتَ تَقُولُ فِي هَذَا الرَّجُلَ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ. What did you say regarding this man who was sent toward you, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? In our qubur, we'll be asked regarding our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nobody else, no other human being. On Yawm al-Qiyamah, Allah Dhul Jalal will ask us, how do you respond to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Nobody else. So in this dunya, which comes before our qubur and comes before our akhirah, why are we worried about making ita'ah to fulan and fulan from the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? Rather, our goal and our objective should be, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created jinn and man except to worship me. And the tariqah of that ibadah is the tariqah of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. As Shaykh al-Islam, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmahullah ta'ala, he has mentioned that the example of our ibadah, the example of our mutaba'ah, of our ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and our obedience to humankind is تجريد العبادة لله وتجريد المتابعة للرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. Is to strip all of your worship for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody other than Him is deserving of any worship. وتجريد المتابعة, and to strip following only to Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nobody in opposition to him is allowed any form of obedience in opposition to him. And I will end with the hadith I began my khutbah with, Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala an, when he said that all of my ummah, all of my nation, from the beginning of them till the end of them, all of them, they will enter into paradise. Kullu ummati yadkhuluna al-jannah, with the exception of one category of people, illa man aba, except the one who they object and they refuse to enter into paradise themselves. The Sahaba alayhim ridwan became perplexed and became amazed. وَمَنْ يَعْبَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Who is that person who they will themselves refuse and object to enter into paradise? He said alayhi salatu wasalam, مَنْ أَطَاعَنِي دَخْلَ الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever obeys me will enter into paradise. وَمَنْ أَطَاعَنِي دَخْلَ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَقَدْ أَبَىٰ. And whoever disobeys me, then they have themselves refused to enter into paradise by disobeying me, by disobeying the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. وَمَنْ أَطَاعَنِي دَخْلَ الْجَنَّةَ وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَقَدْ أَبَىٰ. Whoever disobeys me, and even if they may obey all of mankind, if they have disobeyed me, وَجُعِلَ الذِّلُّ وَالصَّغَارُ عَلَىٰ مَنْ خَالَفَ أَمْرِي. Lowliness and humiliation has been enthrusted upon the one who they oppose my commands sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He allows us to make our feet firm in following the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that He makes us true muhibbeen of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that Allah the Jalal allows us to obtain His pleasure and obtain His mahabba subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innahu waliyu dhalika wal qadiru alayhi hadha ma indi wallahu ta'ala a'la wa a'lamu bis sawab wa وتم إن أريد إلا الإصلاح ما استطعت وما توفيق إلا بالله عليه توكلت وإليه أنيب. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم زيننا بزينة الإيمان وجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان وجعلنا مع الراشدين. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء وألسنتنا من الكذب وعيوننا من الخيانة فإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولجميع موتانا وموتى المسلمين واشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.